home, everybody.
Good morning, Ron.
Good morning, Tommy.
Man, you know, this is so exciting. Today is the day that the Lord has made. And what are we going to do?
Rejoice and be glad in it.
We sure are, you know. So excited, Ron, because last week, Pastor started a brand new series on the power of praise and worship. Now, Ron, I mean, that message alone last week just set me up for success all year long.
It set me up, and I love what he said about it shrinking your problems and building your strength in relationship with God.
Come on.
Whoa, that was powerful. I loved it.
So good. You know, I love how you brought that out. Is it changes our perspective when you think about it. When you said it just shrunk your problems, I mean, our perspective could be, well, you know, I got this big bill. I got this big thing in front of me. I got this, you know, I'm not sure what I'm going to do. But man, when we're worshiping God, all those problems just seem to melt.
They melt.
I mean, and which, honestly, another thing we're doing this year, which ties right into praise and worship, it's our one-year Bible.
The one-year Bible. Oh, man, the one-year Bible is phenomenal.
Yeah.
We're doing it as a church family, and we're doing it at home.
Come on.
And I love it when me and my wife, Tommy, we're talking about the one-year Bible. We're reading it at the same time.
That's so awesome.
Nighttime, and we get two different things.
Yeah.
So guess what? It's a win-win-win when we're reading the Bible, the one-year Bible. So
I love that.
We're growing together.
Come on. Well, you know, and that's what's so great is because this is the year of expansion. We're going to expand this year as a church, but individually. Because as a church, if we're going to expand,
that's right,
as individuals, we have to be expanding, not just in the natural, but we've got to expand spiritually. We've got to be growing, I mean, reading the Word.
Because
faith comes by, is it just listening to the news?
No, doing.
Come on. But not the news.
No.
It's by the Word of God.
By the Word of God.
Listening, obeying, and doing. And so it's an amazing time. But if you don't have your Bible, look, our team's going to post a link in the chat room for you where you can get yours today. So don't delay. And if you fell off the wagon, should they stay off the wagon?
No, get back on the wagon.
Yeah.
Get back on the wagon. Just like Pastor said, we have to build our relationship with God so we can move forward and we can grow. But another thing, Tommy, we have going on, we have a huge event that's going
on.
Come on.
Now,
what event is that that's going on for our church?
This is the biggest thing. Look, it didn't matter if you're single, if you're married, if you got kids, if you're young, old.
Doesn't matter.
I think I covered just about everybody, right?
You got it all.
It's Easter. Easter is coming April the 16th and the 17th. I mean, it's not just a day. It's a whole weekend, Ron.
A whole weekend. You're right.
I mean, on Saturday, we've got an Easter egg hunt. Let's see. What else we got? Bungee trampoline.
Hold on. Wait. Can the adults do the Easter egg hunt?
I mean, you know, I guess if we're with the kids, right? Like, you know, some kids need help.
Right.
I'm just saying, look, please don't post dirty things in the chat room saying like, no, adult, we're just joking about we're not going to get in the Easter egg hunt.
Right.
But we got a bungee trampoline. Now, look, you know adults can get in that.
That's going to be fun. Hold up. Wait. We have face painting, right?
Yes, we do.
The petting zoo.
Petting zoo. I mean, you just can't get better than this. I mean, some little critters running around that you get to pet.
Now, hold up. My favorite of them all, the food truck.
Hey,
I like food.
Look, if everybody likes to eat. So you want to be here on Saturday, the April 16th. If you're planning a visit to St. Louis, if you're from out of town, look, that's the weekend you want to join us. And then Sunday, I mean, we've got three services. Our 9, 11, and 2 o'clock Espanol. It's our Spanish service, as well as a car and motorcycle display. I mean, it's an amazing time. And an invite tool on our website.
Yes.
That you can invite people.
You can't forget to invite them.
That's right.
Share the tab.
Yeah.
Text someone. Give someone a call.
That's right.
Get the invite.
Yeah.
It's going to be an awesome time.
Awesome, awesome. And then this Wednesday, Ron, we got to share this before service starts. This Wednesday.
I think I know where you're going.
Come on. It's the prayer meeting. What time does the prayer meeting start?
6:30.
Yeah, 6:30. And it's both in person and online?
We're online. And
yes.
Hold up. The great thing about this one, our pastor. What is our pastor doing?
He is going to be teaching us on prayer and how we can pray effectively. I mean, it's going to be an amazing night, and we're praying over everybody's prayer request.
So submit your prayer request, bring it to the altar, let pastor pray over them.
Yeah.
And you guys have an open heart and receive it.
Amazing, amazing. So our team will have more information in the chat room for you. Ask a question. But Ron, I mean, you can tell. I mean, the band's getting ready. I mean, we got a double bass behind us today.
Yeah.
I mean, this is really cool, guys. So go ahead, set the tone, set the atmosphere where you're at. Stand up, get ready for church. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
Let's go to church together.
Good morning, church family. Welcome home. Are you excited to be in God's house this morning? That's pretty good, but I think you can do better. Are you excited to be in the presence of Almighty God? Praise the Lord. We're excited. Well, as you can see, we're kind of continuing. Pastor's continuing with his awesome message on the power of praise and worship. So we're just sticking in that unplugged vibe. We're going to be doing older songs, new songs. If you know them, just join in right with us. And then we got really cool, our strings over with us. Give them a big hand clap. So happy they're with us. After service, don't forget, you might have saw people walking around with those big waffle cones. Those are all complimentary for you today. After service, take your kids, go out there, meet some new friends. And then we want to welcome all of our first-time guests. If this is your first time to the church, let's give them a big welcome. After service, head out there to the lobby. We've got a guest center, and you'll see a big sign on the wall, but we've got a free gift for you, a really cool mug, so stop by and get that. And then lastly, we're going to welcome our online family. Yeah, come on, really can clap for them. Thanks for being with us. Get all those distractions out of the room and join in with us on this awesome worship day. Let's do it. Oh,
faithful God. You're such an amazing Lord. There's none that compare to you. Worthy, 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 worthy. You're so good to us, God. Oh, we love you. We adore you. Aren't you thankful for having the Lord in your life? Oh, have you been enjoying this series Pastor's been teaching on praise and worship? Have you been upping your praise and worship? I tell you what, I have been, and especially doing the old songs, you know. I was singing this morning that old one, Majesty, Majesty. Worship is majesty on the way in. And, you know, when you begin to worship God, he just comes with his presence. He just encircles you. And then the Bible says, can I read you scripture? Can I read you scripture? All right. It's in Philippians 4, 6 in the Amplified. And it says, do not be anxious. Do not be anxious. Do not be worried about anything. But in everything, every circumstance, every situation, every problem, by prayer and petition, bring it with thanksgiving. Continue to make your specific prayer request unto God. Well, you see, that's what we've been doing. We've been praising God. We've been worshiping Him. We've been celebrating His goodness. We've been thanking Him for all that He's done for us. And then God says, come on, bring me what your problem. I'm going to take care of it. Do any of you have problems today? Is any of you been having an anxiety or a worry? Yeah. Are you ready for God to answer that prayer? Oh, I tell you, we serve a good, good God. All right. Well, how many have financial problems and say, Pastor Kim, I need prayer for my finances? Raise your hand. How about for your health? Raise your hands. Okay. How about for relationships? Raise your hands. And the rest of you pray for, I pray for that lion spirit. You see, everybody's got problems. We are all part of the family. I don't know of one family that doesn't have a problem. And you know, we're going to pray right now, but you're not going to pray for yourself. You're going to pray for the person on your right and on your left. We're going to pray that God gives them a supernatural breakthrough. Do you believe this place has great faith? Yeah. I do too. And if I ever have a problem, you know what I do? I want the people of Church on the Rock praying for me. They are so faithful in praying for you. Let's pray. Dearly Father, I pray right now for that person on my right hand. I pray, Father, that the Spirit of the Lord comes upon her in a greater way. I thank you, God, that you're going to touch her from the top of her head to the soles of her toes. I pray, God, you're going to give her supernatural wisdom. I pray she walks in great health. I pray, God, that you use her for your glory. I pray, God, the best is yet to come. I pray that her children, God, are taught of the Lord and blessed of the Lord. I thank you for using her mightily, God, in Jesus' name. I pray for the person on the left. I pray, God, for their finances. I pray, God, that you'll begin to bless their health, God. They'll begin to bless whatsoever their hand touches. I pray that, God, there's going to be a supernatural turnaround in this family's life, a supernatural turnaround. I thank you this will be the year of expansion. I thank you, God, they'll begin to walk in a greater anointing, God. Their gifts will be used by you. I thank you, God, for doing it. And everyone said, amen and amen. Woo. God is in the house today. Ah, I love revival, don't you? And we're just beginning. Well, what's happening Friday night? The ladies event. You don't want to miss it. And I'll be speaking on God has a destiny for you. I believe that every woman that is born right now, that you are born for such a time as this. You were born for such a time as this, that God has equipped you to do a great work, which you will not come down from. God has put a calling upon your life. Anyway, I better stop or I'll get into preaching. Pastor won't get to preach. And sorry, guys, you will have had to listen. But anyway, you don't want to miss it. It will be Friday night at 6 o'clock. Make sure you get your tickets. Also, everybody say 9 o'clock. One more time, 9 o'clock. We will be having a prayer meeting. You see, we're just going to continue on. 9 o'clock is going to be an amazing night. The band's going to be here. We'll be having live band. We will be praying for our nation. How many believe the nation needs prayed for? Well, we'll be praying for our nation. We'll be praying for revival. We'll be praying for gas prices to come down. We'll be praying for change, that God's going to do a new thing. I believe that because of you, because of the righteous, the things that are coming upon the earth can be detained until God gets us out of here. I tell you what, get ready, get ready. If you want God to use you, make sure you're here 9 o'clock. What time? On Friday night. And we're going to have an amazing time of praise and worship and prayer. Well, turn around and let's welcome and meet and greet everybody. Say hello to your friends and neighbors. You may be seated. Let's watch some amazing videos.
Hey, online family, come on, let's do a virtual meet and greet. As everybody's meeting and greeting here, saying hi, make sure you're in the chat room, say welcome home to somebody, tell them hi. I mean, we got some shout outs here. Welcome Uganda. Yes, the country Uganda. Okay, I believe your name is Solemnly. If I said that wrong, I apologize, but welcome. Welcome Cedar Park, Texas. Yes, we got, I'm gonna hope I say your name right, Michaela. I might've said it wrong. But look, so many more. We got Ben from Arizona. Look, make sure you're in the chat room. Engage with us. Connect with us. Post where you're gathering from. We want to connect as a church. Now, we've got some amazing videos to share with you. Let's watch them together.
Welcome home.
I'm Paul, and I serve at Creative Arts.
Hold that thought.
That works.
And my name is Leonella, and I serve at the online campus, and we're so glad that you're gathering with us today, whether you're watching online, VR, or live in person, and now, Metaverse.
Yes.
You're at the right place at the right time.
You can bring Church on the Rock with you by hosting a watch party. It's as simple as streaming to your TV or device, inviting friends, family, neighbors to watch this week's service.
And make sure to click the Next Step link
so we can connect with you.
You know, Paul, the greatest things in life are not things, but relationships.
That's right, Leonella. That's why we have small groups.
A place where you can connect.
Build relationships with people who like what you like.
And if you would like to sign up for a small group, make sure you check out our website. If you would like to give today, we have several ways available for you.
You can give through a text message on our website, by mailing it in a giving box on the way out, through cryptocurrency or stocks, and through Cash App.
Thank you for making a difference through your giving. We're thankful that you're joining us today, and we're so glad that you're part of our Church on the Rock family.
Don't forget to visit the Rock Express. And remember, it's also open on Tuesdays from 9 to 1. You can also order on the app, and it'll be ready for you when you get here.
And if you would like to watch today's service again or Pastor's previous teachings, make sure that you check out our watch page.
Once again, thank you for joining us. And as always,
God is for you.
We are Praying Church, and connecting with God through prayer is one of our core values. We are launching our new prayer meeting on Wednesday, starting March 30th from 6:30 to 7:30 p.m. We believe this is the most important service of the week, so join our family of believers gathering together for worship, a teaching from Pastor, and to lift up the needs of our church, our community, and the world. Through prayer, God is going to move in mighty ways as we pray with faith that the Lord will help us in every area of our lives. Nursery, Kids Rock, and Uprising Youth will also be available for your children.
When you're going through a painful experience like I did, you know, separation and divorce, you know, you have that stigma. What are people going to think? You know, shame begins to creep in because, you know, when we go through these painful experiences, the first thing we want to do is hide because we are ashamed of what people are going to say and how they're going to view us. And I felt the weight of having to mask my pain, putting a smile on my face like everything was great and perfect. But inside of me, I was broken. I was in pain and nobody knew it. There was a period in my life where I had to come to the end of me. And that's where I found Jesus, in a sense, right? I've known God all my life, but I think it was through this breaking process that I had a intimate re-encounter with God. Shame disconnects us, not just from God, but from the body of Christ. And it hinders us from finding healing. What helped me stay was pastor's teaching, because every Sunday I would go, every time I would sit and listen to his messages, they were food for my spirit and my soul. And that's what helped me stay. You know, it strengthened me every single week. At my worst, at my weakest, I would sit in service and I would be fed enough that I could then go and serve and give to others. Because it was when I was serving that the pain also was lessened, because I was doing something to maybe help someone or feel a need. And so that felt gratifying. So that also gave me strength to keep going. God was able to help me extract the meaning from that painful journey so that he can grow me into the person that he had created me to be. I wasn't gonna let anything stop me from serving God. God was calling me to a higher purpose, but because of those fears and insecurities, I stayed. I see myself as someone who's been reborn. With this rebirth comes a new level of wisdom that I get to share with other people. And that's my mission, is that what I went through in the past, it's not something to lament or feel like I'm a victim of. Those are experiences and lessons, treasures that I'm going to use to help other people.
Good morning, Church on the Rock. We're so glad you're here today at our second service. We have one more at 2 o'clock, Church on the Rock, Espanol. Can we give it up for our Spanish ministry? Wow. I mean, didn't you appreciate Denise's story? Isn't that awesome? You know, Church on the Rock is a place of restoration, not judging, not condemning, not putting shame on people. I thank God for his mercy is new every morning. Amen. As we get ready to give today, I just want to tell you, thank you so much for being faithful, being committed in difficult times. Anybody can give when things are hunky-dory, but when we're going through difficult times like we are right now, it takes real people of stature, character, integrity, stewardship. You know, God looks and sees how we handle what we have, and if we're good stewards, which you are, then he's going to give you more. Amen. So what I want to do today is I kind of want to do a little lab right here, right now. And, you know, at Church of the Rock, you know this. We are pro-God, and we are pro-family. We're pro-life. We're pro-Bible. Can I have a witness on that? We are, what does the Word say? So I want to show you some headlines from this last week of, I'm going to share some bad news with you from the headlines from Fox and CNN and other news sources, but I'm gonna leave you there. I'm gonna give you some good news at the end, okay? So here's some headlines from this last week. Guys, are gonna put it on the screen. It says, U.S. consumer sentiment fell again amid rising rates, war, and inflation. Next, guys, that's CNN Business. Gas prices throw a wrench into vacation plans. They're telling us that we're going to have staycations this summer because of gas prices, because of inflation, cost of hotels, cost of even camping. Gas prices throw a wrench into vacation plans. Families prepare for a costly 2022 travel. That's USA Today. Another, throw it up there, guys. Let's keep going. CNN, recession risks are uncomfortably high and even moving higher. Our own president said Friday that prepare for food shortages this summer. You go to Walmart right now, there are empty shelves. Target, there are empty shelves. It's a time of inflation. It's a time that is higher than in the last 40 years. Check it out. Next, guys. Weekend reads, the slowing housing market and inverted yield curve signal in a coming recession. This is the news that we've all seen this last week. Next, guys. Fox News, most Americans seeing effects of inflation. Survey claims with many not expecting any relief. Anything else, guys, we have? Next. Hello, guys, next, go to the scripture. Okay, that's enough bad news, right, guys? That's enough bad news. They're telling me back there, Pastor, we don't want any more, amen. But that's the world that we're living in right now after COVID. It's not the same. That inflation, recession, gas prices, food, groceries, war, nuclear threat, cyberspace, a threat, war. I mean, these are dangerous times. But I've taught you that in the midst of everything that's going on, we don't want to put our head in the sand. We want to be sober, alert, watching, praying. Amen. You know, we want to know what's going on, but then we always want to go to the Word. And what does the Word say? We are pro-Word. What does the Word say? So look at what the Bible says in Matthew chapter 6, verse 31 through 34, Jesus. So don't worry. Boy, there should be a difference of being a godly person and an ungodly person, right? We as godly people shouldn't be worrying, shouldn't be fretting, freaking out in fear, upset, or panicking. Why? Because Jesus said, don't worry at all about having enough food this summer, the cost of clothing. Why be like the heathen? The heathen, there's a reference to ungodly people, people who don't know God, people who aren't Christ followers, the non-Christian. He said, don't be like them. So there should be a difference. We shouldn't be freaking out over what's going on right now. Can I have a witness in the house? We should be witnesses, strong in our faith, strong in our relationship with God, knowing what the Word says, and looking at the news and what everybody is saying. It's dark. It's depressing. It's discouraging. If I was without God, man, I would probably go get drunk today. I'd probably go get high without God. And I'm serious because it's terrible out there and it's going to get worse. The persecution for Christians, get ready. I'm preparing you. It's coming in a greater way. So, but what does the Word say? Jesus said, don't worry about not having enough food, not having enough clothing. Why be like the sinner? For they take pride in all these things and they are deeply concerned about them. Next verse. But your heavenly Father, aren't you glad you're in the family of God? If you're not, you can be. Oh, that was kind of weak. Aren't you glad you're a Christian? Aren't you glad you're in the family of God? Folks, you're going to have to rely on a society within society. The early church did in the Roman Empire. There was a Christian society within the society, the culture of the day. But your heavenly Father already knows perfectly well that you need them. You know, God sees ahead of us. And even though even our president said there'll be food shortage this summer, they're telling us not to travel, the cost of gas, staycation. The middle class is being wiped out because we can't afford to do what we used to do with our family and all this. But you know what? God's gone ahead of us and God knows everything is going to happen this year. They're talking about an economic collapse before the election in November. God knows what's going to happen. So aren't you glad you're in the family of God? If not, I'd get there real quick because your heavenly Father, he already knows what you and your family needs. Verse 33. So what should we do? He will give them to you, what? The food, the clothes, everything that you need. He'll help you with the house payment, the car payment, the insurance, the grocery bill. He will give them to you if, everybody say if. This is why it's important to be a tither and a giver and not stop, because you stay connected to Jehovah Jireh. He will give them to you if, it's conditional, you put God first place. in your life, if God is first place in your life and you live like God wants you to live, not our culture, not the universities, not the ungodly, not the world economic system, no, not the elite, but if we live as God wants us to live and we put Him first. How do you put God first place? By giving Him the first day of the week like y'all are doing right now. By giving Him the first part of your income, that's the tithe. By giving Him the first part of your day. By going to Him first when you make a major decision. That's how you put God first. So I would be so depressed if God wasn't first in my family today. God wasn't first in my life today. If I had to depend on the Republicans or the Democrats or a white or black president or woman or a male president, if I had to depend on my job and my career and that was my source, I'd be depressed. I'd go get drunk. But they're not my source. God is my source today because I'm a tither and I'm a giver. He will this year give you everything you need if you make Him first place in your life and you live as He wants you to live. Where do we find that? In the Bible. In the Bible. Next verse, verse 34. So don't be anxious. Don't freak out. Don't be upset. Don't be anxious about tomorrow. God will take care of you, your family, and your tomorrow. Live one day at a time. What does the Word say? If God is first place in my life, and I prove it by giving Him the first day of the week, first part of my income, first part of my day, I go to Him first. If He's first in my life, then He said, I know what you need, Dave, and the Blunt family and Church on the Rock. I've gone out ahead of you, and I've made a way where there is no way. Come on, somebody. So I just want to encourage you with that today. Don't freak out. Put your faith and trust in God. Remain a giver. Never stop, because it will only hurt you and your family. You ready? Let's make our confession together. Say it with me. Lord, we faithfully and cheerfully worship You with the giving of our tithe and our offering. We believe as we sow seed to establish the vision of this house, You will establish ours. As a result of our giving, we thank You for raises, increases, bonuses, gifts, canceled debt, and surprise checks in the mail. We bless You for blessing our health, giving us a sound mind, quality relationships. Now help us, God, to know You as the God who's for us, and to help people discover Your purpose for their life. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you very, very much. the Lord. Come on, let's praise Him. He can change everything. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm echoing real big up here, guys, right now. Before you're seated, tell two or three people, tell them, I'm so glad you came today. Would you tell them that? And then you can be seated. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. I'm so glad y'all came today. Amen. I'm glad for everybody online, everybody VR. Metaverse Church last night, people raised their hands at our 5 o'clock Metaverse Church, got born again. People watching from France, UK, Australia. Is that amazing? That's at 5 o'clock every Saturday. That's another campus that God's blessed us with. I want you to get right in it with me today. We've gone a little longer with worship. We've gone a little longer with worship the last couple of weeks because I'm teaching on it. Y'all got it? Yeah. So we don't want to just be a hearer. We want to be a doer. And so we've gone just a little bit longer. So let's get right into the word today. I want to talk about the power of praise and worship. The power of praise and worship. Last weekend was part one. Today's part two. I believe it's the answer right now for you and I. You know, I have people asking me right now, Pastor, what should we be doing? What should we be doing with everything that could go wrong is going wrong, and the things that we thought would the worst would come, it's coming, I mean, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. What should we be doing? And here's what I tell everybody. We should be seeking God. We should be after God. That's why we're starting the Wednesday nights back up. We should be seeking God like never before. We shouldn't be sleeping. Isolation brings apathy. There are a lot of Christians that have become apathetic during COVID because of the isolation. It's time to wake up. It's time to shake ourselves off and be sober and be vigilant. It's time for us to realize what we should be doing right now is seeking God like never before. Number two, we should be serving God like never before. We should find out what God wants us to do and do it with all of our might. Number three, we should be sharing our faith. Those three things. What should we be doing, Pastor? Not panicking, not being fear, not being worry. Don't shrink your dreams. Don't stop living. Come on, somebody. Don't give up. Don't commit suicide. Don't take drugs. Don't get high, except on the Most High. But what we should be doing is seeking God like never before in our lifetime. We should be serving Him, finding where we're supposed to serve and do it with the best of our ability. And then we should be sharing our faith right now because Jesus is coming back, and I hope He comes back before the end of this service. Really, Pastor? You're supposed to live like that. You're supposed to live like He's coming back today, but plan like He's not coming back in 100 years. That's Bible. We're pro-Bible at Church on the Rock. You should be eagerly looking for Him every day. Really? That's Bible. The Bible says every day we should be looking for His return every day. That's what the Bible says. So I'm teaching on praise and worship because there are more depressed Christians, disgruntled Christians, defeated Christians than I've ever seen in my lifetime. And so the answer to that is put on the garment of praise for the spirit of discouragement. Am I right? So we're looking at it. Last weekend, we talked about, you know, what is worship? And I want to pick up on that today. What is worship? We answered questions last week. What is worship? How do we worship? Who do we worship? But I like what Oswald Chambers, this is a quote of his. And if you're looking for a good devotional, Oswald Chambers, great devotional, one of the best. But he said, worship is giving to God the best. Emphasizing the best that He's given to you. So that means that when we worship Him, it shouldn't be half-heartedly, lukewarm, indifferent, forced to, passive. No, we should be passionate about our worship to God. We should give Him the best of our day, the best of our income, the best of our focus, the best of our devotion. Can I have a witness? Giving God our very best. If I want God's best, and I do, then I've got to give Him my best. I'm not going to surf on my iPhone during worship. I'm not going to come late. I'm not going to be indifferent. I'm not going to be a spectator. I'm going to engage. I have to engage to have an experience with God in church. So worship is giving to God the very best that He's given to you. We're defining what is praise and worship. Worship is giving God our respect and our reverence. Worship is giving God our respect and our reverence. Bringing my Bible shows I respect the Word. Being on time shows I respect the church, the ministry, all that work so hard. You know, we have to be on time for a doctor. We have to be on time at school. We have to be on time at work. We should be on time at church. Worship is giving God our respect. I know a lot of people don't like that, but you got to love me to go to heaven. Worship is giving God our respect and our reverence. Worship is expressing our gratitude. What is praise and worship? The last 25 minutes, we've been expressing our gratitude and our love to God. And it's just not on Sunday, right, everybody? Sunday's a lab, right? It's a lab. We're going to school, and then we live it out during the week. Worship is expressing our gratitude and love to God. Kim and I, this year, 49 years of marriage. If I just told her, pray for us. She's got to put up with me. If I just told her once a week on Sunday that I'm thankful for her and I love her, guess what? We wouldn't make it to 50. We wouldn't make it to 50 years. So worship is expressing our gratitude and love to God. I like this. It's so simple, but yet so powerful. Worship is our response to His attributes. Oh, Pastor, after about 5 minutes, hallelujah, hallelulu, jalapeno, glory to God, thank you, Jesus, my cat, my dog, my hamster, thank you, God. And I don't know what else to say. Well, then work on knowing a knowable God. Work on knowing a knowable God. Find out His attributes. God is good. We sang about it today. He's Jehovah Jireh. We sang about it today. He's Jehovah Shalom. We sang about it today. We sang the Word. I need to work on His attributes. There are all kinds of studies on the attributes of God. And when you begin to focus and take an attribute, just take one for a whole week and just focus on thanking God for who He is. He's the great I Am. I'm thankful He never changes. In a world that's changing daily, really, folks, we may not have our freedom next Sunday. You don't know. I don't know. They may put you back in your house again. We don't know. You don't know. So I'm thankful. I'm so thankful for He never changes. He's the same yesterday. So worship is our response to His attributes. I can't have strong faith and be a strong Christian without being a strong worshiper. I can't have strong faith and be a strong Christian without being a strong worshiper. We want to get skilled. I want to be better. You pray for me. I want to get more skilled at worship and praising my Heavenly Father. We pursue God. Why do we have praise and worship? We pursue God. Remember I said, what should we be doing right now? Not freaking out. Not being in fear. No, when you come here, I want it to be the most positive place you come to all week long. And what should we be doing? We should be pursuing God. How do you do that? I'm teaching on it all month. You pursue God through praise and worship. You pursue God through praise and worship. Now, our flesh doesn't like it, but you have to put your flesh under. To be carnally minded is death. To be spiritually minded is life. We have to put our flesh under, and we pursue God, and those that seek Him will find Him. We pursue God through praise and worship. Through praise and worship, we're going to look at the benefits today, the benefits of praise and worship. Through praise and worship, you get closer to God. You get closer to God. My prayer for you as a pastor who loves you, that every time we gather together, a society within a society, the family of God, this community, you leave stronger and you leave closer to God. Now, if you're not engaging, you won't. But if you're engaging, you will. We pursue God through praise and worship. Everybody say pursue. John chapter 4, how do we worship? This is where we left off last week. How do we worship God? You know, if we went out on the street right now of St. Louis downtown, ask people, how do you worship God? We get all kinds of crazy answers. But let's go to the Bible and find out how Jesus wants us to worship him, right? How do we worship him? God is a spirit. God is a spirit. Pastor, I just wish God would show up. I'd like to see him in a visible form. You know why he doesn't? Because if he did, we'd make statues. And then we'd worship those statues. It takes trust to worship an invisible God. And being an invisible God, you can't make idols as easy as if you could see Muhammad or Buddha or Confucius. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Sure do love you, by the way. Love him, worship him in spirit and in truth. Everyone say spirit and truth. Small s always refers to the human spirit. Capital S always refers to the Holy Spirit. So this is not talking about the Holy Spirit. This is talking about you and I, our human spirit. So he said, those that worship him, you must worship him with all of your spirit, with all of you, giving God the best you have to offer, even when you don't feel like it. It's called the sacrifice of praise. You worship him in spirit, and you worship him, number two, in truth. So we broke it down, and we said that we worship him. The spirit is devotional, and the truth is doctrinal. Devotional and doctrinal. What is doctrine? Teaching the word. So what do? The kind of worship, and I want him to receive my worship. I don't want to waste that time, right? I don't want to say vain repetitions that he doesn't receive. I want God to receive my praise and worship every time, right? So we got to do it the Bible way. We're pro-God, pro-life, pro-family, pro-word, pro-Holy Spirit. So you must worship him in spirit. In other words, not half-heartedly, not lukewarm, not just carnal, not just half-mast, not just half there. And then you got to worship him in line with the word of God. So everyone say devotional and doctrinal. Now this is huge because your pastor loves you so much. I'm setting you up for success. As a Christian, in your Christian journey, as a parent, as an entrepreneur, as an employee, as a student. So Jesus said, if you want to worship me, you worship me in spirit with wholehearted devotion, all in, all the way. And you worship me in line with what does the word say, how to worship me. And then we go to the Old Testament, and we see the same principle in the Old Testament. Right here, 2 Chronicles 31:21. I love this. This is so awesome. Hezekiah, King Hezekiah, incorporated the teaching and the commands into his worship. I love that. Don't you love to sing the word? I love to sing the word. Hezekiah, Pastor Blunt, incorporated the word of God into worship and dedicated his life. You see doctrine? The word commands, and you see dedication, devotional. So when you and I, when we come to church, on our way to church, we should be getting ready. On our way to church, we should be worshiping and praising God. Your kids need to see you do that. We should be worshiping and praising God. And then when we get here, man, we just keep flowing, right? We don't got to prime the pump. The pump's already been primed on the way to church, all right? It's easier for the creative arts. It makes their life easier. It makes my teaching easier, okay? I don't struggle trying to get across the word because people have unprepared hearts. So he says that he incorporated word and he dedicated his life to serving God, and whatever he did for the worship in God's temple, God's house, church, he did it half-heartedly. No, if I'm an usher, I'm a greeter, I work with the lights, I work with the fog, I lead songs, I'm a parking lot attendant, I work with the nursery, I should do it wholeheartedly, take it seriously. He did it wholeheartedly, and look what happened, and he succeeded. Now here's the deal, if we do it God's way, God will bless your life and my life, and we'll succeed as parents, grandparents, entrepreneurs, business owners, educators, politicians, that will succeed at whatever we do if we do it God's way. So praise and worship is not a time to waste. It's a time to do it wholeheartedly. and do it according to the word. The word says that we're to raise our hands. Did you know that? Lifting up holy hands without wrath and without doubting. That means without anger, unforgiveness in our heart, and without doubt, with faith. It says lift your hands up. You know, when you lift your hands up, what does that mean? I'm just giving you an example of next week, because we're to worship God according to the word of God, right? Devotional, doctrinal. Well, you know, when my grandkids were little and they'd run up to me and they'd lift up their hands, what were they saying? Pick me up. Pick me up. Well, my grandkids are teenagers now, but when they were little guys and they'd run up to me, they'd put their hands up, what were they saying? Pick me up, Papa. What are you saying when you lift your hands in the sand? Pick me up, God. Pick me up, Father. Abba, Father. Daddy, Father. Pick me up. What else are you saying when you lift up your hands? Because a lot of people are embarrassed and afraid to lift their hands. And it says, when you lift your hands in the sanctuary, all ye people, not one section. Oh, some people didn't like that. Woo, doggies. God love me if you want to go to heaven. I'm trying to help you succeed. I'm trying to help you get rid of all that junk in your life. You know, I like to watch Western. John Wayne, he's in heaven. You know that, right? Robert Schuller led him to the Lord on his deathbed. Robert Schuller, who's in heaven, led John Wayne to Jesus Christ on his deathbed. So John Wayne is in heaven. I love John Wayne. I still watch John Wayne, this, that, the other, praise God. And so when he catches a bad guy, what do? They put their hands up. What's that? Surrender. Pick me up, Abba Father, and I surrender everything in my life today, the good, the bad, the ugly. Am I helping anybody? Everyone say doctrinal, devotional is God's way to worship him. Can you give that a big praise right now? Clap your hands, all you people. Shout into God with a voice of triumph. Romans 4, verse 20, Father Abraham. This is cool. This is really cool, because this is where I can't be a strong Christian, have strong faith, unless I'm a strong worshiper. And we're all growing together, okay? Nobody's arrived. We're all going together. No unbelief or distrust made him waver. Talking about Abraham. Doubting or questioning God and what God has said. Maybe you're questioning God today. The answer is get to know him. When you get to know him, you begin to love him. You begin to trust him. You'll stop doubting him and questioning him. No unbelief or distrust made him waver, doubting, or questioning concerning the promises of God. But he grew what? That's kind of weak. He grew what? How many want to get stronger? We're all in a warfare today. We're all in some kind of battle today. You got to be stronger than the war you're in. He said he grew strong and was empowered by faith as he grew stronger as he grew stronger as he grew stronger as he gave praise and glory to God. You know what? You and I should get stronger. If we're engaging in the worship at our church, you should be getting stronger by the second, because the Bible says so. If I'm all in, all the way, God has all of me today, and I'm praising him, worshiping him, then as a result of that, I should leave here stronger than the battle that I'm in today. Praise and worship. Wow. The more skilled I get at praising God and giving God glory, the stronger I get in my Christian walk. The stronger I get as a believer in a world gone hostile. Strong enough to handle the persecution that's coming. It's coming, by the way. It's coming, by the way. Yeah. So I want to prepare you to be stronger, and your kids to be stronger, and your grandkids to be stronger than the persecution that's coming your way as a Christian. All right? Got quiet in the house, but you'll look back and thank me. All right? Benefits of praise and worship. Benefits of praise and worship. Five things, okay? Five things. Boy, I love the word, and I know you love the word. Amen. Whew, I'm pro-word. What does the word say? Boy, if I was going by what I read to you in the news, I'd give up. I mean, really, I'd quit. But yeah, there are some people who don't have a clue what's going on. They have no clue what's going on. So look what praise and worship will do. Number one, it helps me overcome discouragement. It helps me overcome discouragement. And we got that spelled a little wrong, but the hopelessness, and get control of my emotions. Did you know that your mouth controls your mind? your mind, your emotions. Did you know that you can control your mind with your mouth? You know what I'm talking about. In the middle of the night, you wake up in a panic attack and you start praising God and it leaves. Your mouth got control of your emotions. Praise and worship, a benefit. It helps me overcome discouragement, hopelessness. Now, our world right now is telling you, you don't have a history and you don't have a future. What's that leave you? Hopeless. Helps me overcome discouragement, hopelessness, and get control of my emotions. How cool is that, everybody? All right. So scripture for that is Psalm 42:5. Psalm 42:5. Why am I so sad? Why am I so troubled? He said, I will. It's an act of our will. It's a choice, right? I'm not going to stay sad. I'm not going to stay troubled. I'm not going to stay fearful or anxious or fretting or freaking out. Why am I so sad? Why am I so troubled? I will. I will put my hope in God. Notice the word hope. Where you put it in? Not man, but God. And once again, what's he going to do? I will praise him. A benefit of praise and worship is it helps you get over discouragement, hopelessness, and get control of your emotions. Why am I so sad? Why am I so troubled? I'm going to put my hope not in the media, not in man, not in the government, not in education. I'm going to put my hope in God. And once again, I'm going to praise him. He's my Savior, not a politician, an educator, not Wall Street, not my neighbor, not my job, not my career, not my intelligence. Ha ha. I will praise him. He's my Savior and he's my God. Whoa. Next, guys. So the next there. Verse 6. Here in exile, here my heart is breaking, breaking heart. So I turn my thoughts to God. Today, if your heart is breaking, then I'm pointing you to God. Today, if your heart is breaking, notice my thoughts. I'm going to turn my thoughts to him. Do you know how you turn your thoughts to him? With your mouth. Because your mouth controls your mind, your thoughts. You take a thought with a word. Well, I hope I'm helping somebody. This is the deal. You take a thought with your words. What have you been saying? Repeating the bad news or declaring the good news? He said, my heart is breaking, and so I'm turning my thoughts to God. That's what you all are doing right now. As I'm teaching the word, I'm reprogramming. I'm brainwashing. I'm changing your focus to get your eyes off yourself, off your sorrow and your sadness, and on what does God's word say. I turn my thoughts to him. He has sent waves of sorrow over my soul. Chaos roars at me like a flood, like waterfalls thundering down to the Jordan from Mount Hermon and Mount Mizar. Next, guys. Back to NLT, same scripture. Why am I discouraged? Why is my heart so sad? I'm going to put my hope in God. Notice, praising God brings you hope. Praising God changes your focus. I will put my hope in God. I'm going to praise him again. I'm going to look for some praise prompters. Praise prompters. I will praise him again. He's my Savior. He's my God. Verse 6, NLT. Now I am deeply discouraged, but I will remember you. I love that. I will remember you. The other translation said, I'll turn my thoughts towards God. It's time to recommit, rededicate, reset, restart, refocus. I will remember you, even from the distant Mount Hermon and the source of Jordan from the land of Mount Mizar. So there we have the first benefit of praise and worship, is that it helps me overcome discouragement, hopelessness, and control my emotions. Am I helping anybody today? Number 2, y'all are out there, right, listening? It helps me get closer to God. and feel His presence. Praise and worship a benefit. That's why the devil doesn't want you and I to do it. That's why it's easier to watch a sitcom. It's easier to get on Facebook. It's easier to twit. Can you still twit? It's easier to TikTok. TikTok, TikTok. It's easier. Why? Because the devil doesn't want us getting close to God. It's easier to come later to church. It's easier not to do it than to do it. Why? Because praise and worship helps me get closer to God and feel His presence. Wow. He inhabits the praises of His people. Oh, my goodness. Leaders are carriers of the atmosphere. Psalm 140, verse 13. The righteous, that's you all, Church on the Rock, our church community, a society within the society, the righteous will praise you indeed. Look at this, how simple this is. And they will live. I don't want to visit on Sunday. See, if I'm having a rush to get in and get out, there's something wrong with my walk. If I'm in a hurry to get out, there's something wrong with my walk with God. I want to be in His presence. I want to be in the multitude of the family of God. The righteous will praise you. And what will happen? They will live. Man, I want you to live there Monday morning. I want you to live there Tuesday when you get a bad report from the doctor. I want you to live in His presence Wednesday when an unexpected bill comes in the mail. I want you to live in it because in His presence is fullness of joy. The righteous will praise you. Do you see how important it is to get skilled at praise and worship? You can live in God's presence. And the Bible says, in His presence, all your enemies melt. In His presence, the enemy of stress and fear and panic and worry and depression, it all leaves in His presence. I like it. Can you dig it? Yes. Number three, it enlarges my picture of God. A benefit of praise and worship. It enlarges my picture of God. I love that. Number one was what? Helps us overcome discouragement, hopelessness, and helps us to get a control of our emotions. My mouth controls my mind. That was worth coming to church today for, or coming online. Your mouth controls your mind. If your mind is whacked out, what have you been saying? Change what you're saying and bring healing to your mind, your emotions. And then we see number two, we'll live in the presence of God. Well, I need His presence. I couldn't make it with one day without His presence. Then number three, it enlarges my picture of God. Praise makes God bigger. Hallelujah. Psalm 69:30. I will praise. I will praise the name of God. The name of God speaks of His attributes. Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Tiskenu, Jehovah Nisi, El Shaddai. I will praise the name of God with what? A song. How cool is that? Pastor, I can't sing. You can read. Well, that was weak. You can read. I will praise the name of God. See, you need God to get bigger than your sickness, than your stress, than your confusion, than your frustration. You need God to get bigger than your financial dilemma. You need God to get bigger than your past. Some of you are living in the past. You need to make God bigger than that hang up. How do you do it? Praise and worship. If I had a magnifying glass up here, you know what I'm talking about. Some of us on our smartphone, there's a magnifying glass, right? I will praise the name of God with a song. And what will it do? Magnify Him. And what is praise? Expressing my thanksgiving. I'm thankful I could come here today. I'm thankful for you to be able to be here today. I'm thankful for our technology to help everybody out there today. I'm thankful for our freedom of the Word of God today. I'm thankful that I'm not being censored, that certain things I can't say, like in Canada or Finland or the UK. You realize that, right? You realize that I heard this. I don't know if it's true. You can't say sin if you're preaching and a preacher in Finland. Come on, folks. Wake up. Wake up. I will praise the name of God with a song. I will magnify Him with my thanksgiving. I love that. Psalm 145, verse 3. The Lord is great. Woo, the Lord is great and is to be half praised, highly praised. His greatness is bigger than your sickness. His greatness is bigger than your confusion, your dilemma, your sadness, your panic, your worry, your fear, your insomnia. His greatness is beyond understanding. Yes. Oh, I like that. How do I tap into that? Highly praising him. Yes. Devotional, doctrinal, in spirit and in truth. Oh, not looking at my watch during praise and worship. Something wrong with me spiritually if I'm looking at my watch during praise and worship. Somebody then got real quiet. Praise God. I'm trying to help you today. Get free. The Lord is great and to be highly praised. His greatness is beyond understanding. I will bless the Lord on Sunday. I bless the Lord at all times. His praise will be just on Sunday or Wednesday, continually in my mouth. If it is that I'm controlling my mind and my emotions and I got my act together, I got my life together, I'm responding and not reacting. The praise cure, I'm responding and not reacting. I bless the Lord at all times, a life of praise in his presence. His praise will be in my mouth. If his praise is in my mouth, then he is in my thoughts. And as a man thinketh, so is he. Can we have a praise break? Come on, let's give the Lord a big praise. Hallelujah. I'm going to skip right through here because the ice cream is melting for y'all out in the parking lot. Hallelujah. Young lions do lack, suffer hunger, staycation, inflation, cost of living, empty shelves at Walmart. But they that seek. What did I tell you what we should be doing right now? Seeking God. Not stressing out, not freaking out. We should be seeking God. We should be serving God because that's going to go into the next life, the next world. You're storing up treasure. And we should be sharing our faith. But they that seek the Lord, what is praise and worship? Pursuing God. But they that seek the Lord, you will not this summer, this year, lack any good thing. You will not lack any good thing if you're seeking God and putting him first. Oh, I like that. I can dig that. I can chew on that. That'll feed my faith and starve my doubt. Number four, it brings answers as the team comes out. It brings answers. Praise and worship brings answers, brings solutions. It brings strategies to all my problems. Whew. It brings answers. Everybody in this room needs an answer to something. Everybody out there, you need an answer to something. Praise and worship will bring answers. Solutions, strategies to my problems. I love that. Problem solving through a praise life. Psalm 73, verse 16. When I thought to know this, when I wanted to understand why it is the way it was too painful for me, David said. Until when I tried to figure it out, I couldn't figure it out. That's just my paraphrase. When I was trying to figure it out, God, I couldn't figure it out. Until I went to church on the rock, then I understood. In his presence, through praise and worship, it brings answers. Things that you don't understand, you can't figure out, you have a dilemma, you're confused, you're divided, you're in indecision, procrastination. And David said, it got too painful for me. I was trying to figure it out. I was trying to logic it all out, reason it all out. But until... when I went to church on the rock, when I went to the sanctuary of God, then I understood. Then I got the big picture. Then I got the revelation. See, it's talking about in the presence of God, praise and worship in the house of God. Wow. So number four, how cool. Boy, isn't that cool back there on that screen back there? You guys are spoiled rotten. No church in town does that, y'all. Helps me focus on the goodness of God. Helps me focus on the goodness of God. Praise and worship helps me focus on the goodness of God. We sang about it today, the goodness of God. He's been good. He's been faithful all of our life. Praise and worship gets my eyes off the bad news I showed you at the offering onto the good news I've taught you for the last 29 minutes. All right, so it helps me to focus on the goodness of God. Psalm 103, verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Your soul's your mind, your will, and your emotions. Your mouth controls your mind. Say that with me. My mouth controls my mind. Bless the Lord, O my soul. So when you leave here today, get in your car, you should be praising God. That was weak. You should be praising God. If you leave here and you don't do anything different, then I didn't do my job and you wasted your time. Every time I come to church, I should be corrected. If I'm not corrected, there's no anointing. Did you know that? If you go to a church, you're never convicted, never corrected, there's no anointing. Because the Holy Spirit convicts and corrects. So every time I go to church, there should be some adjustments. If there's no adjustments, if I haven't changed anything, there's been no anointing. There should be correction, adjustments, edification. If I go to a church, I'm never encouraged, equipped, then there's no anointing. You see, I should always leave different. I should always implement something. Well, I knew that. Well, you're supposed to go to a higher level in that. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that's within me. All that's within me. Wouldn't that be devotional? Wholeheartedly, all that's within me, bless his holy nature. Verse 2. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his. Been focusing on the benefits of God, focusing on the goodness of God. Whoa, changing. It shifts my focus. It shifts my focus. And whatever I'm focused on, I'm feeling. Two words, letter F. Whatever I focus on, I'm feeling. You can focus on what we did wrong here today, or you can focus on what we did right here today. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits. What are they? Verse 3. Who forgives, thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Who forgives all my iniquities. Complete, total forgiveness in him today. Complete and total forgiveness. Who heals all, not some, all. Those known to man and not known to man. Who heals all my... See, you want to focus on this. You want to focus on the goodness of God. It will cause a shift in your emotions, in your feelings, and the direction of your life. Verse 4, the benefits. Who redeems my life from destruction. He protects us. Praise brings God's protection. Praise brings God's protection over your house. He redeems your life from COVID, other viruses, other sicknesses, the flu. Whatever. He redeems your life from destruction. Don't have to live in fear. Who crowns my life with loving kindness and tender mercy. We're looking at the benefits. There's a shift going on as we change our focus. Next verse. Who satisfies thy mouth with good things. God wants you and I to live a satisfied life. A satisfied life with good things. So that your youth, this is your health, this is your energy, this is your strength, this is your vitality, this is your recall. So that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. In closing, I just want to encourage you to work on some praise prompters. Praise prompters. Now, we've gone a little bit longer. We don't usually go this long. And it's just because we went a little longer in our worship. Is that okay? Because it's a lab. It's a lab. It's a training time. And we're studying that subject, so it reinforces what we're studying. But we need some praise prompters. I'm done teaching, okay? Praise prompters. What do you mean, Pastor? You know, to help us throughout the day, because there are some really heavy-duty days coming ahead, and you got to be equipped, you got to be prepared, you got to be all in, or you're not going to make it. So praise prompters, praise prompters. When I'm walking my dog every day, you know, and I'm just walking, I'm thanking God for my dog. What a blessing she is to me. What you know, my four-legged friend. And seriously, and I was walking her yesterday, and guess what? Springtime, the buds are beginning to come out on our trees at our house. I was thanking God that I could be here for another spring. I was thanking God I could walk. You know, at my age, you're just glad you can walk. I was just thanking God, praise prompters. You know, and I was just, I was looking at the trees. I was looking at the buds, new life, new spring, thinking about God's goodness, God's newness. Behold, he makes all things new. You need to work on some praise prompters. You might want to put on 3x5 card or a yellow sticky on your mirror, at your house, in your bathroom, in your bedroom, in your car, on the dash. But we need some praise prompters. We're going to have to be intentional. And we're going to have to be, you know, on purpose, because it doesn't happen by accident. I'm done. Did you get anything today? Come on, let's thank God for the word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, come on, your best phrase. Hallelujah. Father, thank you for our church. Thank you for one another. Thank you for the anointing. Thank you for the Holy Spirit. Thank you for the Word of God. Thank you for our freedom. Thank you for our nation. Thank you for revival. Thank you for Wednesday night church. We're going to do something about it. We're not going to complain. We're going to gather and pray. Hallelujah. Revival in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Y'all are awesome. Would y'all stand with me? Our prayer team's coming forward right now. If you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, give your life to Him today. Maybe you've walked away from Him during COVID. It's time to come back to Him today. Nobody's going to judge you at Church on the Rock. Nobody's going to put you down. We're here to serve you and help you today. Our host is coming to close, but as they come today, I want you to know, I love you. I'm praying for you all week long. Would you pray for our family when you pray over your food?
Yes.
God bless you. Have a blessed week.
What we're focusing on is what we're going to feel. Pastor taught us today how we can bring answers, solutions to the problems that we face today. Powerful message through praise and worship. I want to encourage you, if you know somebody, maybe they're struggling with something today. Maybe they're going through something. They're focusing on the wrong thing. Make sure you share this message with them. But this morning, if you made that decision, maybe for the first time or as a rededication, you say, God was tugging on my heart. Pastor talked about it. When we come to church, we should feel the Holy Spirit to convict us, to correct us. If you felt that this morning that, you know what, there's something different I need, making that decision for Christ, we've got a class for you. It's our New Believers class. Right there on the screen, you can text the keyword new to the number 636-442-4260 or scan the QR code. We want to connect with you. And then two, we want to connect through our dream team right there. You can start connect. You can start serving today through Growth Track. We've got another class to help you grow, but to connect with us here at Church on the Rock, where you can start serving. Say, Tommy, I want to get plugged in with Church on the Rock. It's through our Growth Track class. Scan the QR code right there or text the keyword team. Again, thank you for joining us this morning. I want to encourage you, this Wednesday night, we start our Wednesday night services. It's the prayer meeting at 6:30 Central, right here on our online campus. So cotr.org/online, that's where you can join us for the prayer meeting. Or if you're local, come join us in person. We would love to see you. Again, thank you for joining us today. We'll see you Wednesday. And until then, never forget, God is for you.